Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Educate. We're going to be doing Coulomb's Law today. This applies for both grade 11 and grade 12 in electrostatics. So I strongly recommend a grade 11 learner to hearken unto these teachings in such a way that they will apply next year in metric. So now, let's talk of first the electrostatic force. You often hear the calculations asking you to calculate the electrostatic force, and you often wonder what is an electrostatic force. So to first understand that, we need to know that charges exert a force on each other that is known as an electrostatic force. So an electrostatic force is only just a force between two charges or two charged objects, and that force can be an attractive force or it can be a repulsive force. How do I mean? So in grade 10, you have learned that when you have got two charges, let's say this is a charge and then this is a charge, these are two charged objects. How do I know that these balls are charged? They can write that just a charge here. Let's just say four millicoulomb or something like that. So they can write 4 millicoulomb, and then this is just another sphere. Sphere B can be written something like negative 2 millicoulomb, and then you are told that they are placed at a distance of 2 meters or something like that. And then now we need to know that these are two different charges. We see that these are charges because you can see that there's something measured in coulombs there. Remember, charge is measured in coulomb. So if A, this is A, A is positively charged because we can see that its charge here is positive 4 my millicoulomb, whereas B is negative 2 millicoulomb. So we have said that in grade 10, oppositely charged objects attract each other, meaning that when you've got a positive and a negative, they will attract each other. And when you've got a negative and a negative, they repel and all that. So that repulsion or that attraction is known as an electrostatic force. So here in this case, we need to have a trick of using free body diagrams to represent the force. Remember, each and everything that is to do with force in grade 11 and in grade 12, you need to use a free body diagram to represent it. So now let us just draw the free body diagram for A that is indicating the electrostatic force that A is experiencing from B. So because A and B are oppositely charged, B is going to attract A. By that, it just means that its arrow, the force for the arrow, is going to point in that direction. This will be the force of B on A. So we'll label it the force of B, the force of B on A. So here it is. So this is a free body diagram for A that is representing that A is being attracted by charge B. Why are they attracting each other? Because they are oppositely charged. So you need to know how to draw free body diagrams. So now in this case, this arrow is pointing to the left, or to the right, it is because B is on the right of A. So it's more like B is pulling A towards itself. Okay, so this arrow is indicating force, a pulling force. This B is pulling A towards itself. And this is known as an electrostatic force. In this case, this is an attractive force because we've got opposite charges. But when you've got another scenario with like charges, it's going to be opposite. So let's try to draw the free body diagram for B. So if we draw the free body diagram for B, this is its dot. Remember that we need a dot first to represent that this is a free body diagram. And then its arrow is going to face in that direction. This is going to be the force of A on B. So this is what's happening here. So here in this case, you can see that A is on the left of B and they are attracting each other. They are attracting each other, meaning that A is also pulling B towards itself. B is pulling A towards itself, whereas A is also pulling B towards itself. So that is why the arrow is facing to the left, because A is on the left of B and A is attracting. Remember, the word attract just means you are pulling closer. So in this case, because these two charges are oppositely charged, then That is why A is pulling B and B is also pulling A. So it depends which flipped diagram are you drawing. For A, the arrow is going to face to the right because B is pulling A to the right. And for B, the arrow is going to face to the left because A is pulling B towards itself, which is to the left. And then now, what if there are like charges? If we've got like charges, let's just name them C, and another one, let's name it D. And then let's just say C has got a charge magnitude of negative 2 nanocoulomb, and D has got a charge magnitude of negative 7 nanocoulomb. So these are two charges, and both of them are negatively charged. How do we see that? You can see that this number here that is measured in coulomb, or the charge, is negative. So C is negatively charged and D is also negatively charged. And remember that you have said that like charges repel. So they do not pull towards each other, they push each other. They push each other away from each other. They do not want to be in the same. Yeah, and they don't want to get closer, they want to get further away from each other. And for that to happen, let us just represent that using a free body diagram. For C, we're gonna draw a dot. So this is the dot. This is the dot for C. And because D is on the right of C, and D is repelling C, it is going to push it to the left. So it's going to push it to the left. This is the arrow indicating the force of D on C. That's why I say force DC. And then as for the free body diagram of D, we can say that C is to the left of D, and C is the same charge as D, so it is pushing it to the right. So the arrow is going to face that direction. This will be the force of C on D. That's why I say force CD. So these free body diagrams really help you, because if there's attraction, you know that the arrows are pulling towards each other, of both free body diagrams. And if they are repelling, the arrows are pushing away from each other. So this is more like a pulling force happening in the unlike charges, whereas in the like charges, it's a pushing force. Even if we have got two positive charges, let's just say this is E and then this is F. Just have this is a charge E, this is a charge F. Let's just say this charge E has got a charge of 2 millicoulomb and F has got a charge of 8 millicoulomb. Both of them are positively charged. How do you see that? You can see that both of them have got positive charges. So what happens to them? They're going to push each other away. So now to draw the free body diagram, let's just draw the free body diagram of E. Because F is on the right of E and it is pushing it away, it will push it to the left. This is the force of F on E. You see, this is the force of F on E. And then for the free body diagram of F, we say that in this case, E is on the left of F, and E is pushing F away from it, so it will push it towards the right. So this is the force of E on F. And for you to draw all of these free body diagrams, you just need to see, are these charges attracting or are these charging, are these charges repelling each other? All of them have got a force, and it's known as an electrostatic force, but it can either be an attractive force or a repulsive force, depending on the nature of the charges. If they are like charges, they're going to repel. If they are unlike charges, they're going to attract. So now, taking this mathematically, we need to know, how do we actually calculate that force? Because remember, force is a vector quantity, according to what you learned in vectors, that force is a vector quantity. It has got a magnitude, or the size of a force. It's a number, and it also has got a direction. In that previous slide, you can see that in this case, this force was to the left. This force was to the right, this force was to the left, this force was to the right, something like that. So in this case, force also has got a magnitude or a size and also a direction. So now the law that is used to calculate the force between two charges is known as the Coulomb's law of electrostatic force. So the Coulomb's law states that the magnitude of the electrostatic force exerted by 1 point charge on another point charge is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. Please know this definition exactly as it is, because each and every keyword matters in this definition. And we write the Coulomb's law mathematically as F is equals to K Q1 Q2 over R squared. So this is the equation that we use to calculate the force that two point charges exert on each other. So for example, if you have got a charge A with 4 nanocoulomb and a charge B with 2 nanocoulomb, these two have got a repulsive force, right? They repel each other. So when we draw the free body diagram of the 4 nanocoulomb, it's going to face this direction because it's being repelled, right, by the 2. So we say this is the force of the 2 nanocoulomb charge, the force of the 2 nanocoulomb charge on the 4 nanocoulomb charge. And then here for the free body diagram of the 2 nanocoulomb one, we're going to face in that direction because it's being repelled by the 4 nanocoulomb charge. So this will be the force of the 4 nanocoulomb charge on the 2 nanocoulomb charge. So in this case, do you notice that now you ask yourself that this equation that we have here, which force is it calculating? Is it calculating the force of these 2 on 4, or maybe is it calculating the force of 4 on 2? So these two forces are actually the same size. They've got the same size or the same magnitude. So the force is between two point charges is equal, right? Is equal, but then it is in opposite direction in this particular case. So this force F24 and force F42, it is the same force, because it is a force between two point charges. So in a question, if they ask you, calculate the force that the 2 nanocoulomb charge exert on the 4 nanocoulomb charge, you still use this equation. So now let's just break this equation down, the Coulomb's law equation. So the Coulomb's law equation has got these postulates. So the first one, this F is representing the force. This is the electrostatic force. So this is known as an electrostatic force. This is the electrostatic force between two point charges. And then this K, it is known as a Coulomb's constant or a proportionality constant. And it has a value of 9. It's 9 times 10 to the power of 9. And then Q1, it is the first charge. Q2 is the second charge. And R, it is the distance between the charges. So this is the distance between the charges. So now the thing is, if we have got this statement, this Coulomb's law, and we just want to relate the force and the distance and the charges, we need to know that the force, the electrostatic force between two point charges, it is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the charges. So the force in this case is directly proportional to Q1 times Q2. These are the charges, just like the magnitude of the charges measured in coulombs here, right? So it means that if you are using bigger charges, they will have greater force of attraction between them. So they are directly proportional. So the bigger the charges, then the bigger the force between them. And then now the force is inversely proportional to the distance, the square of the distance between the two charges. So it means that if there is a greater distance between these two charges, there will be a smaller force. Yes, of course. The distant you are from each other, the lesser force you have on each other, something like that. So that's why I don't recommend long distance relationships and stuff. But now, so applying these two to calculate the electrostatic force, what are we going to do here? We are just going to say that the force between these two, let me use a black pen. So we say that the force between these two, you can say the force of 4 on 2, or you can say the force of 2 on 4, it is the same force, but in opposite directions in this case. So now we're gonna write, this is K, Q1, Q2 over r squared. Then all you do is to substitute. K is a constant, 9 times 10 to the power of 9. And then Q1 is the first charge. In this case, the charge here, it is 4 times 10 to the power of negative 9. Remember that the smaller n here, it is just standing in 4 times 10 to the power of negative 9. And then the other charge here, Q2, it is the other charge, which is 2 times 10 to the power of negative 9. And then over the distance between them, let's just assume here that the distance between these two is 20 centimeter. But remember that in physics, we do not measure distance in centimeters, we use meters. So to convert this to meters, you're just going to have to divide this by 100. So when you divide 20 by 100, you're going to get 0.2 meters, and then you square that. Then you put that into the calculator. Whatever answer you get, you measure it in newtons. And if we say that force is a vector quantity, how do we describe its direction? In this case, we describe the type of force that we have. So if here, specifically here, I've said the force between 4 and 2, even if you say the force between 2 and 4 is the same, but then you have to say, is it an attractive force or is it a repulsive force at the end? So in this case, these two are repelling each other because they are both positive charges. So you say this is a repulsion, or you say a repulsive. Yes, repulsion. So now this is how you calculate the electrostatic force using Coulomb's law. You're just going to say the Coulomb's constant multiplied by the first charge times the second charge over the distance between them squared. Yes, that's pretty much all. So let's just try to do some practice problems to see that are we coping with this this thing. So now question 7 here says two point charges P and T are placed 0.03 meters apart. The charge on P is positive 36 times 10 to the power negative 6 coulomb. So this is the charge on P. You are given the first charge here. Let's just name it Q1. This is the first charge, the charge on P. So let's just say this is Q1. It is 36 times 10 to the power of negative 6 coulomb. So anything measured in coulomb, it is what? It is a charge, right? So the charge on P here is positive 36 microcoulomb. And then now, the charge on T, you can see that T is carrying a charge of positive 16 times 10 to the power of negative 6 coulomb. So this is the charge, the second charge that we have here. I'll just name it Q2. And then now the distance between them is 0.03 meters. It means that P and T, they are placed 0.03 meters away from each other. 7.1 says state the Coulomb's law in words. Whenever they say state the Coulomb's law in words, you need to just state this whole statement. The magnitude of the electrostatic force exerted by one point charge on another point charge is directly proportional to the product of the magnitude of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. That's how you state Coulomb's law. And then I'll skip 7.2 because we have not yet done the electric field pattern, and go to 7.3. 7.3 says, calculate the magnitude of the force, the magnitude or the size of the force that the charges P and T exert on each other. So we are looking at the force between P and T. Since we have said that if we have got two charges, they exert a force on each other. So now to just say here, to calculate the size of the force or the magnitude of the force, remember we use the Coulomb's law. So the Coulomb's law says that F is equals to K Q1 Q2 over R squared. So this is the electrostatic force or the force between charges P and T. So in this case, this is the force is equals to, you plug in K is given by 8.99. You use 9, positive 9, positive 9 times 10 to the power of 9 times the magnitude of Q1. What is the size of Q1? The first charge in this case, it is 36 times 10 to the power of negative 6. And then the second charge here, it is 16 times 10 to the power of negative 6 coulomb. then this is all over. The distance between P and T, or the distance between these charges, is 0,03, and it is measured in meters, so we do not need to convert it. Then we put A squared. So the force that we get there, the electrostatic force between them, it is going to be 5760, and we measure force in newtons, remember. And then now you have to mention what type of force is this. Is it an attractive force or an repulsive force? So remember, we check the nature of the charges. Are they both positive or are they both negative? So in this case, you have got P and T. P and T are both positive charges, so they will be a repulsive force. So you're gonna say repulsion at the end to indicate that the type of force you have here is between two like charges and they are repelling each other. So this is how you calculate the electrostatic force, or the force that P and T exert on each other. So let us try one more. So here you have got two charged spheres, P and Q, with charges of negative 0,7 microcoulomb. So this is Q1. I'll just say this is Q1. Q1, this is my first charge, P, which is negative 0,7 microcoulomb. And then this negative 7 microcoulomb, you have got another charge which is positive. This is Q2, which is positive 0,9 microcoulomb. And then these are placed 18 centimeters apart from each other. So this is the distance between these two charges. So they are placed 18 centimeters apart in a straight line, as it is shown in this diagram. So now the question says, calculate the electrostatic force between P and Q. Remember that to calculate the force or the magnitude of the electrostatic force, you just say that force is equals to K Q1 Q2 over R squared. And all you have to do is to substitute. K is 9 times 10 to the power of 9. And then Q1, the first charge here, it is 0,7. Remember that if the charge is negative, for this formula, even if the charge is negative, in this formula, you only substitute a positive number. So this is 0,7 times 10 to the power of negative 6. Remember that this symbol micro just means times 10 to the power of negative 6. It's a prefix. And then Q is 0,9 times 10 to the power of negative 6. And then this is all over. The distance between P and Q is 18 centimeters. And because it is measured in centimeters, we cannot use it. Remember that in physics, we use meters as our standard units for distance. So in this case, to convert centimeter to meters, we're going to divide by 100. So dividing 18 by 100, we are going to get 0,18, and then this is going to be squared. So our force there between these two charges is going to be 0,175 newtons. And then now let us state this type of force. Is it attractive or repulsive? How do we see that? We check the type of the charges. Are they negative, positive, negative, negative, positive, positive? So in this case, these are unlike charges. This one is negatively charged. P is negative 0,7 microcoulomb, whereas Q is positive 0,9 microcoulomb. So these are oppositely charged, or they are opposite charges. So opposite charges always attract. So this will be a force of attraction. Here we go. This is how you conclude. This is the force, or this is the electrostatic force between P and Q. This is the force between P and Q. Doesn't matter even if you don't write this, but then this is how we calculate the force between two charges in a straight line. So now let's just try to look at something that is a bit more complicated in a sense, but not really complicated. So here we are given 3-point charges A, B, and C with charge magnitudes 4 micromillicoulomb, negative 5 millicoulomb, and negative 6 millicoulomb, respectively. Charges A and B are at a distance of 4 centimeters, and A and C are placed 10 centimeters from each other. So now the question says, calculate the net electrostatic force on charge B. So nothing changed here because we are still calculating the electrostatic force, but then in this case they said net. So the word net just means the sum of things. So we are summing up the electrostatic forces that B is experiencing. So now, because you can see that B is negatively charged, it will experience a force from A and it also experience a force from C. So we just calculate those individual forces, then we add them up together because we want the net, or we want the sum, the total of both these forces. So they are all acting on B. So in this case, if we look at B, let us just try to see that between A and B, how much force do we have? Remember that we calculate force using this equation. So this is the force that A exerts on B. So this is the force of A on B. We're going to calculate it using Coulomb's law. K, Q1, Q2 over R squared. And then now substituting, K is 9 times 10 to the power of 9. And then Q1, we're going to take A and B, right? So we're going to use those charges. In this case, A has got a charge of 4 times 10 to the power of negative 3. And remember that this prefix, small letter m, this m just means milli, which is times 10 to the power of negative 3. And then this is Q2. Q2, we want the force between A and B, right? So we're going to use this as our Q2, which is 5 times 10 to the power of negative 3. Remember, this 5, we do not substitute the negative into the equation because Coulomb's law, which only put the magnitude or the size without the negative sign. Then now over R, which is the distance between A and B in meters. Between A and B, you can see that there's a 4 centimeters. So this is the distance, but then it is in centimeters. We have to convert it to meters. So to convert this, we're just going to divide by 100. So dividing this by 100, we are going to get 0.04 and then squared. So you punch that in the calculator, you are going to get the force of A and B. That is going to be equivalent to 1.125. times 10 to the power of 8 newtons. So it is an attraction indeed, but then in this case I just want to label it and say this is the force to the left. So I say this force is to the left. Why do I say that? In fact, I was supposed to draw the free body diagram first of B. So let's just use a dot. This is the dot representing the free body diagram of B. So now you can see that A is positively charged, B is negatively charged. So it means that A is going to pull B towards itself. So this is the arrow. This is the force that A is exerting on B. Remember, we've done free body diagrams and said that when A is positively charged and B is negatively charged, A can pull B towards itself. So you can see that B is being pulled or is being attracted towards A. So that is why I've said that this force, it is to the left. And then now, it's fine. You can say attraction indeed, but then in this case, I just wanted to say to the left so that it is clear enough. And then now let's look at C. Between B and C, what type of force exists there? It is a repulsive force. Why do we say that? You check B has got a charge of negative 5 millicoulomb, whereas C has got a charge of negative 6 millicoulomb. So both of them are negatively charged. So it means C is going to push away B towards that other direction, towards the left. So the force of, let me just draw a bigger dot dash here. So the force of C on B is also going to be in this direction. This is the force of C. This is the force of C on B. Do not mind the arrows that I'm using to represent the size of the arrows because in this case, I have not calculated the size to see how big each and every one of these is. But then this is the force of C on B. Why is it facing that direction? Remember, C is negatively charged. B is also negatively charged. So B will experience a push. C is on the right of B. So it will push it to the left. It is pushing it. Remember that repulsion means they are pushing it. Whereas A is attracting it in the same direction. So now let us now try to calculate that force, the force of C on B. How much force does C have on B? We use Coulomb's law to calculate that again. This is K, Q1, Q2 over r squared. There's a mark for the formula. You need to always include it in the calculation. So now substituting the known values, this is 9 times 10 to the power of 9. And then this is multiplied by, because we are computing or we are calculating the force between B and C, we have to put the magnitude or the charges, Zara B and C. So in this case, B has got a charge of 5. So we're going to use the magnitude 5 times 10 to the power of negative 3. And then we can see that C has got a charge of 6 times 10 to the power of negative 3. Remember, we do not substitute the negative sign. So now what is the distance between B and C? We know that the distance between A and C is 10 centimeter. The distance between A and B is 4 centimeter. So to complete this 10 centimeter, it means that the distance between C and B is 6 centimeters. You're just going to say 10 minus this 4. You get the remaining distance, which is 6 centimeters. But because this is in centimeters and we use meters in physics, we're just going to convert this 6 centimeters to meters. That's going to be 0.06 meters. Then you square that. And then when you square that, you put that on the calculator. What you're going to get is 7.5. times 10 to the power of 7 newtons. And in this case, the direction is also to the left. Remember that C is pushing B to the left away. So now we want to calculate the net electrostatic force, meaning that we are calculating the sum of all the electrostatic forces that are acting on B, right? So now to calculate the net, remember the word net just means the sum or combination of certain things. So let me just write it here and say that the third thing that we need is to find F net. But then you can see that these forces are all going in the same direction. We can just say that we can just take this direction as negative or positive, whatever you want. But I'll just say left will be positive. Let left be a positive direction. So it means to find my F net, I'm just going to add these two forces. In this case, I'm adding the force of A on B, then I'm adding it with the force of C on B. This is the force of C on B. So now what is the force of A on B? I've calculated it and I found that it is 1.125 times 10 to the power 8. So this is 1.125 times 10 to the power of 8 newtons. Then plus, I'm going to use a plus. Then the force of B, remember the force of C on B there, it is 7.5 times 10 to the power of 7, and it is positive because I've chosen left as positive. So this is going to be plus 7.5 times 10 to the power of 7 newtons. Then the total that I will get there is going to be equals to 1.875. This is 1.875 times 10 to the power of 8 newtons. And then the direction of this force is still going to be to the left. So this is the net force that B is experiencing. Remember, net force just means you are adding these two forces. So if you don't have good background on this, I strongly recommend you that you should first practice how do vectors work, because electrostatics will most likely work with vectors. So in this case, this net force, it is to the left because both of these are pushing and pulling to the left. A is pulling B to the left because it's attracting it towards itself, whereas C is pushing B away from itself. So it is pushing it to the left as well. So that is why we say the net force here, it is to the left. And also, since we have chosen left as positive, so our answer here, you can see that we have got a positive force. That is why I say it is to the left. I hope that this video was very helpful to you, and I will continue making more videos based on electrostatics, and good luck for your final exams. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and stay tuned.